means that the reduction emission from deforestation and degradation. We can do that using like mitigation and adaptation, but we put plus mean safeguard for the biodiversity and also social. This is for the people. In our case, of course, we try to find a flagship species under threat, of course, who, of course, this is a threat, not only for the domestic awareness, also for the international. We are asking like a support, not only money, but of course, this is like a public awareness. We assume also the premium price of the carbon under red plus is higher than red skin. Why we use orangutan as a flagship species under our special case, DLN? Because there are at least 5 reasons why we choose this. The first one is the only great apes living in Asia is orangutan. This is from the literature point of view, of course. And of course, the second, you are expert, of course, in the orangutan or great apes. 97.8% this is similar like us. And already explained that we have similarity in the disease. Right, maybe this is like tuberculosis. This is also, we have to put attention on that case. And also, the most important thing is, if you conserve orangutan, of course, we are also playing important role in stabilizing forest ecosystem. Under our experience that if we keep 1 to 10 orangutan per square kilometer, it means will be 5 species. This is very useful for hornbill. Yeah, hornbill. This is bird in Kalimantan or in Borneo. And also there will be also 50 species of fruit trees and another 15 species of trees also will be viable. And the third one, this is very, you have to put attention on that, the threat. We have very big threat, not only in Indonesia, of course, in many places in the world. That the habitat and also species management of orangutan, this is also under big challenge. Maybe for example like land use conversion, this is big issues. And then species management, like if they already convert the habitat of orangutan, then they lost the habitat. And then if the orangutan play or trying to search like a feeding in the palm oil, then they suddenly kill. This is also a big challenge for us. And then lack of community and public support and change of financial consideration. This is, I will show you, this is the habitat of the orangutan in Borneo and Kalimantan side. This is no threat. And then threatened population. Why we put threatened population? No threat means that the habitat of orangutan now is already conserved under conservation forest. This is what we assume. And then threatened population, of course, this is belong to another land use entity, like production forest, like timber plantation. This is, even we already adopt RSPO, this is maybe for example, but this is still questionable. This is some effective threat management, of course. This is under national park. This is what I'm going to talk. Surely, this is already in the conservation area. Surely, that orangutan will be conserved. But in other area, in the yellow, this is still question mark or big challenge for us. This is, we have a big threat like a forest fire. And then we have forest conversion to the palm oil. This is also logging with, and then forest conversion to other uses. This is very bad. Please consider seriously. Don't follow.
Okay, suddenly.
Okay, this is big story, big challenge for us. Okay, and then assuming that all of the big threat we consider, then we assume that the blue one, this is very good habitat for the orangutan Indonesia. But other, this is still a big challenge. And then, why we use orangutan as a flagship species in the DIRET in the Sabang National Park? Because we already investigated that Sabang is the one of the habitat for the orangutan. And the secondly, this is very important to be talked to all of you, that the government of Indonesia realized since 2004 those habitat located in the what we call as timber concession. There are 13 timber concession available there. This is overlap with the habitat of the orangutan. Then the government of Indonesia 2004 tried to convert it not in the under of the forest production classification, but now is under conservation status. It means there is no legal cutting anymore. This is only for the conservation and environmental services utilization. And then of course, this is opportunity for us to be considered why we choose this area. This is, I will give you very simple explanation. This is maybe for example, if we keep in the Sebangu forest under forest production, it means the carbon stock will be decreasing very sharply. This is in the first graph dealing about the ideal things. If you do sustainable forest production, it means the stock will be like chain. But if you do unsustainable forest production, this is like red. But now under 2004, with WWF Indonesia, of course, we are working together with WWF Indonesia. We make a cooperation. Not only in Sebangu, we have like in Berbak also with London ZSL, Zoological London Society. This is also one of the example in Berbak. Also dealing with the peat swamp forest. Also, but not for orangutan. The flex species is elephant and tiger. This is different. This is, of course, we assume that under conservation forest, the carbon stock will be remain constant. Yeah, constant. But with some effort, this is what I'm going to tell all of you, the carbon stock will be increasing sharply, yeah, year by year. Yeah, what kind of the activity, I will tell you later on. Okay, then we preparing some methodology, of course, with the WWF, with some expert from Canada and then UK also. We using like the theoretical background. If 1 meter reduction of the water table level in tropical peat will result CO2 emission of 90 ton hectare per year. Yeah, this is the philosophy. This is boreal and then temperate and tropic. We use the green one. Yeah, the green one. So 1 meter peat swamp forest underwater, it means 90% ton hectares per year will be keeping. This is the philosophy. Before we use methodology, is we use like a tunnel blocking, and then using we established already 468 tunnel blocking. And then we describe that before canal blocking, the elevations, you see 244, this is not underwater, but after canal blocking, now is almost underwater. So based on this calculation, we have like rel, reduction emission level. So this is, we have like reduction emission level, and then we calculate the prediction by establishing the canal blocking, and then the result will be maybe after 10 years. After 10 years, there will be number 10 million tons carbon will be reduced in terms of the emission. Okay, So if we assume that by canal blocking we can reduce the carbon emissions, then what is the link between conserving habitat of orangutan and then with increasing of the quality of the orangutan? There are two indicators will be used, namely orangutan density, and the second one is orangutan nesting. There are two indicators will be used in term of can we prove after a certain period that the orangutan density will be increased, and also the orangutan nesting also will be more higher than 10 years period. We use the methodology of orangutan transect. This is in Sebangun National Park, and the result maybe for example like this. In the year of 2010, the total density of individu, this is 1.2 till 1.6, yeah, orangutan per hektar. Maybe after 5 years, can we increase? Maybe for example with 1.6 to 2.0, or after 10 years, maybe 2.0 until 2.4 orangutan per hektar. Okay, next, this is. While we are treating like demonstration activity of rats, while we are waiting the buyer of the carbon, then what should we do with the people? We should create what we call as alternative income for them. There are two policy given to the community. The first one is we give a permit to the people who live inside or nearby to the Sebangun National Park or to the project by giving like we allow for the non-timber forest product, like they take a resin, rattan, fruit, and honeybee. And the second one, this is under construction. This is big challenge for us. Can we realize? Can we prove it that ecotourism, this is like one of the alternative income? Yes, at least there are four activities. The one is creating like a master plan by considering accessibilities, and then creating attraction. Attraction will be two, but can be natural, and another one is artificial. In term of orangutan, we allow for mass tourism, but with a certain condition. There is no direct sea or direct. We need like interpretation, like a barrier, and then we need like interpretation. We can do it. Maybe in the bos, in the Nyaru Menteng, yeah, Nyaru Menteng part of bos foundation, there is a site with a special treatment. Everybody can see orangutan activity without touching, without making orangutan make a stress, yeah, like stress. This is the way we can do it, especially for the orangutan who not possible to be released again to the field. This is for the education, for the conservation education, to increase the public awareness. We can do that. But in terms of the natural, of course, we need like map of interpretation. This is what we do in the Sebangun National Park. We consider like accessibility, and then we also consider this is side of tourism, okay, it's okay. And then we also consider the people who live nearby to the site area. There are three villages, and then of course we try to educate the people to be like guide. This is guide, and then also operator of the transportations in order to make it possible to earn money from the visitor. Our calculation is something like that. This is at least there are three kind of type of income will be. The first one is concerning operating of the like a boat or motorcycle, and then will be a guide or selling a souvenir. This is in term of the attraction, and then accommodation. This is will be like homestay. Making like a food available for the tourists. This is the calculation based on our assumption, of course. This is not real, of course. The last but not least, we assume that our activity in terms of direct after maybe 10 years or 5 years or 10 years, there is a buyer, then we will earn money. And then the money will be spent again to the people and also for the conservation. According to our regulation number 36/39/2009 on the demonstration activity, the revenue will be divided into three. The first one is 50% will be to the national government. This is will be delivered again to the national park management. And then 30% will be to the regional government, and 20% will be given directly to the community. And then the community, this is not fresh money, but this is like revolving fund. This is revolving fund under community development scheme program. I think this is all my presentation. I use a picture from WWF, BOSS, and the Schumacher. This is my source picture. Thank you very much.